If you've made it deep enough into the knife world to somehow stumble upon this video, then there's a pretty damn good chance that you've already listened to, or at least, at the very least, heard of the Knife Nuts podcast. The chances are, if you've heard of or listened to the podcast, then you've probably heard of Brian Nadeau. And if you've heard of Brian Nadeau, well, then I would sure shit hope you've heard of this. The Sharp by Design Evo Typhoon, designed by an angry New Jerseyan as a custom or mid-tech, and every once in a while produced in limited and sometimes painfully exclusive runs by the CNC-running witches at Rayot Knives. Now, if you're watching this video, chances are you're like me, and you've missed out on every single run for one reason or another. But fear not, my cutlery-loving brethren, for there is hope. Because I picked up this virtually untouched, brand new inbox Evo Typhoon with my card inlays on the secondary, get this, for retail price, which, considering how insane the secondary can get with knives like this, I feel like that it's, you know, something of a miracle. But if it can happen to me, a skinny schmuck from Ohio that makes knaf videos, well then surely it can happen to you. This is the full-size model, the OG if you will, but for those of you with smaller mitts than mine, which would honestly, you know, be impressive, there is also the mini Typhoon and the micro Typhoon. Now, I've talked about designs being quote-unquote clean in the past, but how do I put this? This thing is fucking clean. Full stop. When it arrived, I could have sworn it was an integral because the tolerances are so insanely tight that it is extremely easy to miss the seam running down the back spine. The contoured titanium scales are stonewashed to this magnificent finish. Like, I'm not a knife wizard, and I sure shit don't have a doctorate in, you know, knife lingo and terminology, but I can't tell you if this is even stonewashed or if it's bead blasted. I have no idea. What I do know is it's absolutely flawless. The pivot, along with that wild flipper tab, are some of Brian's swan songs. The pivot screws give off this emptied revolver kind of vibe, you know, and that flipper tab, as gnarly as it looks, it really is something special, but we'll get to that shortly. The pocket clip is this satin-finished and elegantly upswept piece of titanium, and it's held on by a single Torx screw. And though it is a bit tight, it carries really well, and it's a breeze in and out of the pocket. Nice and secure. And those micarta inlays nestled into the titanium handles are just as wonderful to hold as they are to look at. Exceptionally done. And on the lock bar side, the inlay actually covers the lock bar, making this kind of a bolsterish lock knife. We do get a lanyard bar here at the tail end of the handle, and not that I would ever use it, but it's there, if that's your thing, and I really like the way it's been done. Completely unnoticeable, totally out of the way, unless you decide to throw some braids on it. And just below the lanyard loop are these nice looking and functional little cutouts that both add to the looks and help add just a touch of grippiness in the palm. Closed up, the blade nestles into the handles almost completely, with just the tiniest bit of that beautiful belt satin peeking out, and opening this piece up only makes things better, aesthetically. Now, Brian is not one to shy away from giving the consumer options, and I don't mean like a few color options or finish options. I'm talking inlays, blade materials, blade shapes, sizes, etc., etc., etc. And in the case of my variant here, we're working with this stunning clip point style blade done up in satin finished M390. And honestly, to me, it almost seems Bowie-esque, I guess. And we've got this nice, clean fuller running about 80% the length of the blade. And up top, at the blade spine, we get some really nice jimping for help in the grippiness department. The profile of this knife is, it's really something. Opened or closed, it's striking in that it is so beautifully understated, with just the right amount of flair, and no extra nonsense. So, all of that being said, the aesthetics, they get a big ol' weight plus from me. Moving on to the ergos, well, as I said before, this is the full-size Big Daddy Evo Typhoon, so you've got plenty of room for choking up or choking back, and the natural grippiness from the micarta against the palm, along with the subtle jimping on the blade spine and on the butt end of the handles, gives you all the grip you'll need for most any EDC task. Mix that in with the gentle contouring of the scales and sweeping lines on the underside of the handle that guide your fingers into place, and you've got yourself an ergonomic home run. You can kind of choke up and use that wild flipper tab, kind of like a trigger pull area, but strictly speaking, we do not get a purpose-made finger choil. But I'm alright with it. Oh, and that pocket clip, it just disappears in the hand. All in all, the ergos are wonderful. But this being the most expensive knife I've ever purchased, I can confidently tell you that the day it arrived, the last thing on my mind were the ergos. Like all new knives, that first flip is almost always the most important. So buckle up, kids. Because the action here, it's something special. If you've seen my review, or any review of the Mini Buster, that's next We Knives collaboration, you've probably heard about the interesting twist on the lock bar insert and detent system. Now, I'm not going to pretend to know which system came first, and honestly, I don't care, but let me tell you. Brian here, he's working some serious magic. The lock bar insert and detent is all one piece on the Typhoon here. Where it's usually the lock bar insert with a divot and a ball inside, in this case, it's all one piece. There is no ball, just a beautifully sculpted piece of steel that acts as the detent, and just so happens to lock the blade open. And the level of smoothness here is mind-blowing. And I'm not even talking about the bearings or drop shinies, blah, blah, blah. I'm talking about the fact that somehow, some way, the detent system feels completely frictionless. And if you've handled a lot of knives, you'll know what I mean when I say, how the fuck, Brian, you witch? No surprise here, but I'm a big nerd. Hence why something as simple as a little nub and a steel can get me so riled up. But it's like magnets or some shit. I really can't even describe it to you. It's like it's there when you need it, and it's gone when you don't. Like, the detent goes through a wormhole in between the closed and open position. And the detent system is paired with a big blade running on some of the smoothest, most silent, and centrally controlled bearings I've ever come across. It isn't guillotine drop shut, but it's so damn good, and it's so eye-wateringly smooth and well-behaved that I could give two shits about drop shuttiness. It's one of the most impressive and different and interesting actions I have ever felt. Oh, and I got so wrapped up nerding out on the detent system that I forgot to talk about that big gnarly flipper tab. Looks-wise, you can love it or hate it. Doesn't matter, but it works, and it works flawlessly to kick that blade out. Without fail. The shape makes the actuation a completely and utterly mindless task. Like, there's no wrong way to do it. And it is so endlessly comfortable that I can sit and flip and fidget away for hours and hours and hours and never feel the slightest bit of discomfort. Action is another home run for the Evo Typhoon. Really, you need to try this. You need to borrow one so you can understand what I'm talking about, so I don't feel like an insane person. And one last thing. This is really a flipper only, but you can, however, get the reverse flick and the thumb flick in. The issue is you really have to want it. And you have to really dig your fingers in there to get it done. It's a coin toss for me. Some days I can get the reverse flick and thumb flick every single time, and other days it's like a different animal altogether and none of it works. So take that how you will. The point is, the flipping action, the intended action, is amazing. Just amazing, wonderful, beautiful. And finally, that blade, that flat ground satin finished M390 clip point blade, is not only nice to look at. It is a purpose-built, atom-splitting cutting machine, nice and slicey, stupid thin behind the edge. The blade stock isn't crazy thick or anything, so that helps keep that final cutting geometry just as slicey as possible. And I may baby this knife, but I still open packages in the mail, and I put it through the lighter EDC tasks when I'm carrying it, and it's just a pleasure to use. Now, I don't know, it's hard to explain, it's not the sliciest knife in history, it's not even the sliciest knife in my collection, but it's such a joy to use. Maybe I'm blinded by its beauty when I use it. Maybe it puts me into some kind of lover's trance. I'm not sure. But as it stands, as of the writing of this review, cutting performance is top notch. So after all is said and done, where does that leave us with the Sharp by Design Evo Typhoon made by Rayot and designed by an angry man from New Jersey? Well, I am absolutely smitten with this thing, and I wish I could give you a link so you could run out and buy one for yourself, but I can't. All I can tell you is to get on the waitlist, follow Brian on Instagram so you get the heads up on the next pre-order, and keep those eyes fully peeled on that secondary market, because with this new front flipper he's got on the way, I'm guessing some people might be looking to trade up. You want this. Believe me, you need this. And if I ever hit the lottery, I'll buy all 400 of you an Evo Typhoon. Myself. I'll do it myself. Fuck it. Just so you can understand anything I've said in the past several minutes. It's so good that it's taken me over a month to get this review out, because every time I've sat down to write it, I forget about what I'm doing and I end up staring at it and caressing it and fondling it and sniffing it and inside of me and shoving it. I'm sorry about that. So until next time, thank you for watching. Bye-bye now.